Typically, whenever we're working with an existing Gradle project, we'll be using the wrapper, because that way we can ensure that everyone working on the project is using the same version of Gradle. For our purposes, however, it'd be a bit of a pain to generate Gradle wrapper scripts for every single one of these folders, so we'll have you use a local installation instead. You can find these instructions in the course repository under 1.02 Exercise Install Gradle. These instructions will have you first check that you've got a working Java installation, and then we'll walk you through the process of installing Gradle. Note that if you're on Mac and you're a Homebrew user, that's a very easy way to install Gradle. Also on Mac, there is the GVM, the Groovy Environment Manager, and that will also automatically install Gradle for you. Those are some good options to check out. So let's walk through the process of installing Gradle manually. First, let's check that we have a working Java installation. Looks like we're good to go here. If you don't have a working Java installation, there are instructions for how to install that in the course repository. Now we need to download Gradle. Head on over to gradle.org/downloads to do so. We want the complete distribution. Once we have the Gradle complete distribution downloaded, we need to do a bunch of other things to get Gradle installed. We need to move it to an appropriate place on our machine. Our suggestion is user local Gradle. And then we also need to add a few environment variables. You can do all this by yourself. However, if you just paste in this giant block of script into your console, that'll do it all automatically. All right, here goes nothing. There we go. Gradle has been extracted to user local Gradle, and now we're ready to rock. By the way, if that last command complained, you might need to run it with sudo. All right, let's see if Gradle installed correctly. Hey, there we go, that's looking good. Gradle 2.3, ready for action.